More now on where the president's fellow Republicans stand now that we know the president did ask Ukraine's leader to look for dirt on Joe Biden. Former Trump 2016 rival Senator Ted Cruz of Texas reading straight from the White House talking points.
So for months and months and months, it was all about Mueller. Mueller, Mueller, Mueller. Now, right now, they're all screaming Ukraine, Ukraine, Ukraine. I got to say, the transcript sure didn't live up to its billing. Investigating election interference into 2016 is a perfectly legitimate and appropriate law enforcement priority that the Democrats have been talking nonstop about Russian interference. I'm not sure why they somehow think Ukrainian interference shouldn't be examined.
But it's not all that black and white across the GOP. Many Republicans do say they don't support how the president handled that phone call with Ukraine's president. Some say there are more questions to be answered here, like Congressman James Comer of Kentucky.
I don't think there was anything improper, but I welcome more investigation. And I take my role as a member of the Oversight Committee very seriously. I'm open to hear what role Giuliani played. I'm open to hear more about the other server and what other information may be in that server.
Where are we in the sense that it's been a pretty dramatic 48 hours? First, you do get the summary, the memo on the call with the president of Ukraine, and it speaks for itself. Then you get the whistleblower complaint, and again, it needs to be investigated, but some pieces of it are clearly credible, clearly corroborated by other information. Are there cracks, any significant cracks, I guess is the best question, in the president's party?
I don't think that we've seen any significant cracks yet, but I do think that just as this has moved very quickly on the Democratic side, where it's almost like flipping a switch from we're not going to do impeachment to, okay, now we really are, and we're going to maybe move very quickly. Republicans on Capitol Hill, this is now becoming real. And they see, given that there is documentary evidence, a transcript, a whistleblower complaint, a whistleblower who's been deemed to be credible by top intelligence officials, that they need to leave themselves a little bit of room here, the way that you just heard Congressman Comer doing, to not just close the door on the possibility that there may have been wrongdoing or something that they might want to later point to as, okay, well, that crosses a red line. And you heard a little bit of that at the House Intelligence Committee hearing yesterday, and you're going to hear, I think, a little bit more of it, but certainly you're not going to have anyone jumping ship at this point.
Right. I think that's
the Republicans.
I think that's the key. It's preserving the space in case this gets worse, because the one really, I think, powerful line in that whistleblower complaint is that while they describe one phone call, they make clear that this has happened other times. And so Republicans have to be wary of just how much more there is to come, and that there could be something that looks actually worse than what we've seen in the Ukraine phone call. They also are keenly aware of their politics. They don't want to be seen as abandoning the president until they have more information. But they also know that this is not the full extent of the evidence that's going to be on the table.
Right. If that part of the whistleblower complaint also, and again, the parts that have been able to be corroborated have been, what the context of the call with the president of Ukraine, the idea that the White House does put some documents in a more secret, high security server, conversations with, say, Crown Prince Bin Salman on there, conversations with Putin in there, does somebody inside start talking because of the pressure of impeachment? Look through the history books, that's how it works. But it is interesting to see the different Republican responses. Here's Senator Marco Rubio. The president can do a lot of things I don't agree with. That's why we have elections. Senator Rubio essentially saying, don't impeach, have an election about it. Rick Scott, also from Florida, would I say things the way he said them? No, I don't. Okay, let him be president. Essentially, again, leave it up to the voters. Ron Johnson, it's just the president being President Trump. John Calco of New York, Congressman, if I were president, I wouldn't have done that. It's just the president being President Trump is an interesting one to me, in the sense that are the Republicans, if that's your position as the Republicans, there will someday be a Democratic president. Maybe it'll be in a year and a half, maybe it'll be in 4 years, maybe it'll be in 8 years. So the official position of the Republican Party is it's okay to do what the president did on that phone call to any future Democratic president. It's okay to have a personal attorney who runs around the world doing closet foreign policy. Is that the new position of the Republican Party?
A great number of Republicans are also trying to keep their space open by saying, oh, I haven't read it. Biggest news of the week, the complaint's been out.
Anybody, I'm sorry for interrupting, but anybody in the United States Congress who has not read this by now should resign. I'm sorry, no, we punish our kids if they don't do their homework. Your kids get failing grades if they don't do their homework. It's 10 pages. It's 15 pages. If you want to read the call from Ukraine and the whistleblower complaint, it's fewer than 15 pages combined. If you haven't read it by now, get another job.
It's them strategically refusing to do their homework because Congress is up on a two-week break. They want to see how the public opinion breaks down. NPR poll yesterday that was out, president's approval rating is, I think, 90% with Republicans. 93% at this point disapprove of the impeachment inquiry. They're worried about their base. They always are. They're afraid to break with the president. They always are. One senior Republican source close to McConnell's thinking in the Senate says there's not a single vote at this point for convicting and removing the president from office.
Right, but so we watch. So we watch. Having lived through the Clinton impeachment, facts change, things change, climates change, moods change. We're going to look at public opinion. Here's one of the Republicans. I have several on my list to watch closely. Here's John Thune, the majority whip, a member of the Republican leadership. I'm not a fan of the way, in many cases, the president goes about this, and I would prefer he would not raise an issue like that with a foreign leader. It makes sense for all of us to take a deep breath and just wait and see where the facts lead. I've watched somebody like Senator Thune, a senior member. I watched the retiring Lamar Alexander from Tennessee, who was a young aide to Howard Baker, who's famous during Watergate for asking the president, what did the president know and when did he know it? There are some older, more establishment voices in the party who have long done this about President Trump, who we should watch as this plays out.
Yeah, and I think a lot of Republicans, I mean, think about the position that they're in. They don't want to go too far out on a limb criticizing President Trump because so often in the past, these things seem to hit President Trump and bounce right back off. He has not been brought down, whether it is by the Mueller investigation or by Access Hollywood. And so to go too far and abandon him at a time like this would be putting yourself in political peril. But there are these older members, maybe more old school institutionalists, who are concerned more broadly beyond their immediate electoral prospects about what this means for the future. And they're going to start to say things like, we need to investigate this more fully. I wish he hadn't said this. I wish he hadn't done this. But the reality is, the political reality for Republicans is that their party will accept a lot of what President Trump does. And so if they can afford to get reelected without a majority of the Republican Party, good for them. But a lot of Republicans cannot.